Have you ever heard of the bystander effect? It's a psychological phenomenon that explains this. You are less likely to help someone in need when others are present. Now, I think the Bible explains a story that helps us see the bystander effect in full force. It says that a lawyer asked Jesus, "What shall I do to inherit eternal life?" And Jesus says, "Well, what is your understanding of that?" And so the man responds and says, "Well, if I love the Lord my God with all my heart, strength, mind, and soul, and love my neighbor as myself." Jesus looks at him and says, "You have answered correctly." And then the Bible says that the man, wanting to justify himself, says this, "Well, Lord, then who is my neighbor?" And Jesus answers with a parable. He says that one day a certain man was making his way from Jerusalem to Jericho. Did you catch that? A certain man. The Bible doesn't say his religion. The Bible doesn't say his race. The Bible doesn't say his social status. It just says a certain man. Now, as this man was on his way, this road was very dangerous, this Jericho road. Thieves came upon him, beat him, stripped him of his clothes, and robbed all of his possessions, leaving him half dead on the side of the road. Now, first comes bystander number one. The priest. The priest is on his way. He looks to the side of the road, and I can imagine he's thinking, "Oh, this is a busy road. Someone else can deal with this." Bystander number two. Then comes a Levite. The Levite looks at the situation and is thinking, "I am so busy. I'm about my father's business. I need to get to the temple. I have work to do. I can't possibly get my hands dirty with this." And so he too goes on his way. But then comes a Samaritan. Now, the Samaritan was known as the outcast of society. No one really mingled with the Samaritans, but the Bible says that the Samaritan was moved with compassion, and he immediately acted. He didn't wait for anyone else. He says, "This is my neighbor." And so he begins to tend his wounds. He puts oil and wine on the man's wound. He puts the man on his animal. He takes him to the inn. He pays for all of his expenses. And so Jesus looks at the lawyer and says, "Well, who was this man's neighbor?" And so the lawyer responds, "The one who showed mercy on him." And Jesus said, "You answered correctly again. Now go and do the same." You see, friends, in my life, could it be that I have acted as a bystander? That when I see others suffering and in need, that I have responded like the priest and the Levite instead of the Samaritan? When Jesus used the word neighbor, it was a specific word that he chose. In the original and the Greek, it means any man, any woman, any child, any person that is in need and that you help them, regardless, get this, of their race or their religion. To show compassion, it doesn't matter what they believe or what they don't believe. When we see someone suffering, when we see someone in need, we must respond like the Samaritan. Because friends, it is true that if you are in need, regardless, you are my neighbor, you are my sister, you are my brother in Christ. So I challenge you, this week, respond like the Samaritan.